apron. Oh, and I wish I would have thought you were doing it.
No, you're the trainer.
Here. I'm the trainer. Stop.
Yeah, now you tell him what he's doing right. Or what he should do. What should he do? Here, come, let's go.
I don't know. He's saying here, come.
Here, come.
Say it nicer and pat your leg.
Here, come. Here, come.
Good, your work. Perfect. And keep going. So tell me everything that you see that is done right or wrong.
Here, come.
So that was right. As soon as he started going away, he called him back. He's waiting for him to calm down, which is good.
Right. How do you feel your husband's energy right now?
I don't know.
How do you feel? Is he intense? Is he kind of cool about it?
Here.
He's more cool about it than
okay.
I am.
Is he more strict? Is he more soft?
He's more strict than I
okay.
am.
Okay.
Okay. Here, come.
See, he called him as soon as the leash started getting taut.
Right. So a little bit, could be a little bit earlier before the leash ends.
Here, come.
You see what he does? When he said, here, come, the hand goes automatically. This is not right.
Oh, it's not
because
right.
Here come means they're going to yank on the leash.
Did you hear that, Joe?
No, I missed it.
Okay, don't yank on the leash when you say here come.
Your hand naturally goes backwards.
And here, that's come. A negative.
Yeah. Here come. Here come.
Good. Let's go all the way back again and let's talk about it a little bit as you go back. Now, the dog pulls on the leash, here come, the dog comes back, it's rewarding. The dog pulls on the leash, comes in here come, and it's the reward. The dog is pulling on the leash.
He's learning to pull to get the treat.
Exactly. So what we do now is, we're going to call him back, ask him to sit, then reward, and then go back again and try that routine again. And then after he does it on his own right, and then reward that.
Did you hear that, Joe?
Let him get away the time and come back and then sit.
Yeah.
Because we have to stop the rewarding cycle. So we don't reward when he makes a mistake. We're going to do the whole thing again until he makes it right, and then we reward that. Yes,
here,
reward.
Come.
Yes, that was good. Good timing, reward. Perfect. You see what he did? As soon as he felt discomfort, he looked up to you like, I'm going to lose my poop right now, right? And he totally right, called him in.
We go again? First one this way.
Good point. That was good. Good timing. Good.
Here. Come.
Yes, good. Keep going.
Here. Come.
You see how the homework now applies?
Yeah.
He has no clue what's going on. He's like, what are we doing here? Why do we sound? And he checks in with exactly what you want. And okay, he's like,
okay, here, come. Here, come.
Okay, give another shot. Clicker helps you because you can reward the behavior as it happens in distance and then announce the treat to come.
Here, come.
wanting to meet or holding him back? Think about it.
Well,
do it again.
Yeah.
Do it again. He's like, what? I didn't take the treat again, man.
Yeah. He's like, wait a minute.
That was my bad. Come on. We're going.
Now I like your voice. That I like what he just said to him. It was kind of like a fun game. Sorry, we screwed up. Let's try it again. So less military, more like daddy thing.
Come. Come.
Good.
Go.
Perfect.
Go meet.
Yep, yep. Keep going. Yeah, it's good.
Go meet.
Hello. Here. There. Hello.
Good point, Josh.
So what you can do is you can marry the extremely helpful, mothering,
sit,
caring, and the very strict controlling into in between. Yeah, sometimes we have to be straight, sometimes we're controlling, but usually we're very fun playing the mistake. So it's not a big deal of making a mistake, let's try it again and then make it right. Make sense?
Yeah.
And that tail is the dog, like that. Because if you start yelling at him, it's like, what did I do wrong?
He loves our training sessions,
right,
especially the here come game when we're in the house and we're moving around. We did it outside in the yard one time and we were moving from place to place in the yard and he was having the best time, hung out, tail wagging.
So tell me about the dog park again.
Yesterday?
Yeah.
Well, we went and I was actually getting ready to go and he started playing with another dog named Walt.
Oh.
So the dog park that in Monmouth has two sides, a small dog and a big dog side. And so yesterday, because I know you had said if he goes to the dog park and there are not the normal people, that it could be trouble. So we went to the small dog side first because I thought then he could kind of run along the fence and sniff around. So then I took him to the big dog side and I went up to the people and I asked them, because he was on a leash, I asked them, is it okay if he comes and meets you first? I go, I'm trying to introduce him slowly to new people because he's not used to it and our trainer said it. Normal people. So they said, yeah, that's fine. And he went up and sniffed all their hands and then just walked away. And,
perfect.
And so then I let him off his leash and he was fine. Yeah. He doesn't usually go around the people very much. So
that
he
was a success.
Home.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Wait. So what's our next project?
Well, I don't know. That's going to help a lot with the loose, because he pulls me through the streets.
Right.
So that game right there will help a lot with the loose leash walking so that he won't pull as much.
So how long did it take you to have him on a loose leash right now?
Like one time of doing the exercises?
Right?
Yeah, and then he gets it right away.
And then it's more about you navigating between your thoughts and your actions and bring that always to that consistency so he can adjust to that consistency as well.
Okay.
Because usually what we do is we change the words in the situation, we do every time something different and he doesn't see a particular routine. Understand?
Yeah.
And he's a guy who kind of likes things to be a certain straight way. He doesn't like many changes.
Yeah, I just told Jared this morning, he doesn't really like weekends. He likes the weekdays because I'm on a schedule and we have a set schedule on what we do. And when things deviate from that, he gets more upset.
So the older the dogs get, the less flexible they are on changes.
Calm down there. You're supposed to chew it at least a little bit.
The other thing, did you want to talk about the anxiety or did you want to talk about something?
What's the
he has separation anxiety.
Yeah.
When Joe leaves for school, because he'll leave at like 10, that's when I notice he starts barking at me for like 2 hours straight until we go on our lunchtime walkies.
Okay. So how about you guys go for a walk after he leaves?
Okay, right after he leaves.
Right after he leaves.
Okay.
And then he doesn't have to have that problem.
Okay.
Because he sees the walk as calming himself down, so he barks at you, do something because I'm stressed, I need to get my stress off on the walk. So if you take him out for a walk and stress is over, he will stop barking and he's like, oh, we're good.
Okay, he barks a lot in the car too. Would a walk before a car ride help?
That's a different protocol, but basically what you do is you start the same thing with you with your hands, with a reward. You let him know we're gonna work on the treat and I'm gonna move the car.
Okay.
And you're gonna watch him on the mirror what he does. Here, come, forget it. And he's like, whoa, what happened?
He's like, right? I'm trying to.
And so in the car, the moment, watch what the trigger starts. When exactly gets he anxious? When you start the engine, when you put your seatbelt on, when you put the handbrake down, where exactly does it trigger? Because he will trigger at some point.
Okay.
And when you find that trigger, then you introduce him, if I do this, gets you that. And he's like, oh, I heard that noise. Where is it?
Good. Now he doesn't look at the street.
Okay.
And then what you do is you continue the tossing and try to keep him under that threshold where he's not getting upset about barking stuff.
Okay.
Okay? And then once in a while you start reducing the amount you threw backwards. Okay? Good, nice job. Thanks for not getting crazy. We're on the way there. We are right there. Don't worry about it. Toss another one.
Okay.
So spread the time that you're tossing. Less and less and less. And finally you're gonna give him a treat when you start, and you're gonna give him a treat when you arrive because everything was perfect.
Okay.
You can make it in the first run, it can take you also a month. So it really depends on how you perceive it and how accurate you find the trigger.
Okay.
So as soon as he pants, you're too late.
Okay.
Okay? So find the time where it really starts.
Okay. No, it's okay. I don't have a treat for you.
So one other thing you can do is start with individual pieces of that exercise. We go in the car, we're sitting, that's it. And we go outside. And he's like, well, we're gonna drive? No, why would we?
Okay.
Like, we got in the car. So what? Getting in the car doesn't mean we're moving. Oh, so I don't really get scared about us moving in the car because I just got in the car. No, don't worry about it.
Okay.
Okay, and then you start the engine, you close the engine and see what he does. Like, okay, are we driving or what? Are we here? Yeah, we are here already. Oh, that was it? Yep, that was it. Like, cool, okay, next time it's like, oh, we're not going far, we're just going in and out and we're good, right?
Okay.
And then you start to make the first movement, second movement, right turn, left turn, and start those turns that you get upset about.
Okay.
Yeah, sometimes they get nauseous because what's happening outside is not in alignment with what they're doing inside. It's kind of like sitting in a train and suddenly the other train moves and you're like, oh,
yeah.
I almost fell down. That's kind of happened sometimes.
Okay.
So, another key with that leash that you have, that zipper, you can put it over his harness, so the zipper opens up and you can...
Oh, with his vest?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, we know.
Yes, they're ordering things with this one.
Yeah, it's kind of a hassle because, you know, we have Charlie, and so my mom was coming to sit with Charlie.
Oh, I see.
So that he wasn't left home alone.
Yeah, yeah.
And so we were trying to get that, her and my niece in with Sally, and then trying to get introduced. So when she pulled up, I opened the door and he was barking aggressively at the car. But as soon as she got out and started talking to him and Charlie, his ears went from up to down. So he wasn't being aggressive barking. He was still barking, but his ears went down.
Yeah,
the
guy's cool.
He knew my mom, so
gotcha.
That was good.
So how do you like online training?
It's okay. I thought I found this much more helpful.
It is, right?
Yeah, I'm more of a monkey see, monkey do person. So if you show me, I'm like, oh, okay, I get it.
Yeah,
so it's harder with the online. But, I mean, he's made huge strides just in personality and becoming. He comes at the dog park every time I call him. He comes over. So.
Because you're awesome.
And I'm so proud. I almost cried when he played with that other dog yesterday because he's never played with another dog besides Charlie. And so it was the cutest thing.
Well, the dog park too, he does, like, kind of like you were saying, where he looks to her a lot for what to do when he gets nervous. So.
And so I always call him over because that's what he told me to do.
You can also tell him, keep going, he's good. Knock yourself out, he's a girl, good girl.
Okay.
And he's like, oh, it's okay to stay there? Yeah, totally, you're good. And once in a while you call him. So let him play longer. Like, oh, I'm worried about stuff. Like, okay, I don't see the problem. Oh, no? Oh, I can stay longer? Yeah, stay longer. Like, you're not calling me? No, keep playing.
Okay, because after a while when I start calling him a whole bunch, then he just starts hanging around me because I have treats and he knows I have treats, and then he won't go off and be a dog.
I tell him,
I go, go play, go be a dog. I tell him, go play.
Well, that's exactly what I'm thinking. Do that and end up with, okay, come, let's go home.
Okay.
When you see him like, yeah, but I don't feel good. Okay, let's go back.
Okay.
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 So if you need more help, we can add another session with you if you guys need to.
Well, I got his pinch collar because he told me if I brought it to
you,
give me another session.
Oh, here you go. Yeah, absolutely.
So we brought a pinch collar.
Yep, that's it.
For another one,
are you not going buying pinch collars and giving it to me?
No, the training place that I told you I was going to, they recommend these to help, and because he pulled so hard, we got, you know, that for him.
How do you feel about that?
I never liked those.
Here.
We first started using them on Charlie because he's 80 pounds and he was dragging me through the street. So we started using them, and so that's why we got one for him. But after we stopped I switched him to this, he was 10 times happier to go on the walk because he was more excited to go. And then he's still dragging me through the street with his harness, but this will help a lot, what you just showed us, because that was the other... You told me to get a toy for him, but he doesn't like toys.
Oh.
So I was going to see if I could find something that had a treat that I could put like treats in, and then give it to him when it's outside, because then he'll carry it with the treats, and then when he got home, he could have the treats.
Exactly.
But I haven't found a toy yet, but
it's not a toy, it's actually, it looks like a pencil carrier with a zipper in it.
Oh, okay.
Right?
So, here's my concern about that, because you did show me that to have people, when they come into the house, carry that so that he won't bark at them.
Yeah.
He got a hold of a, because we live by a grade school, and the kids throw their food out, and he got a hold of a cookie in a plastic bag. And I was walking him and Charlie on my lunch, and I tried to take it from him, but he wouldn't let me. And so I thought, well, I'll just wait till I get home because I have two dogs. I can't let Charlie go. So we walked, best walk he ever did with that cookie in his mouth. Didn't try to eat it, but you know.
That's why I was thinking giving him that so he can hold on to it.
When we got home, I tried to take it from him, and he was doing this, and I was afraid to get bit. So I went.
The reason why he wasn't coming up to the dog. So let him carry it. Last like 20, 30 minutes. Once he drops it, we know he's come to zero.
Here's the problem. He ate the bag and the cookie.
Okay.
So I called the vet and we had to force make him throw up because...
I had a bag with two bags.
Well, I would know if he would. That's what they said. They said it probably would pass through, especially because he had puncture holes in it from chewing.
Yeah.
But I was worried then if I got that pencil bag and there were treats in it, if he would try to eat it.
They are good ones. So. They are dog level. And you can actually make one out of leather.
I can't. Maybe you can make one out of leather.
But think in that direction.
Okay, because I was just worried then if we did something like that was cloth, he would eat it.
Well, it's not. So. It's kind of like strong plastic.
Okay.
It's foaming too.
Okay, so he couldn't swallow. Like,
no.
Okay, because he swallowed that bag whole, basically.
Yeah, it's about to be easy to swallow. But you can give him also something like a no hide, which he can carry home and then he can chew when he's home.
Okay.
You don't need that anymore, right?
And he's like, oh, I like that. So, but yeah, his personality, my biggest thing I noticed is the difference between him and Joe, because since Joe stopped like wrestling with Charlie, he'll come out and lay on Joe, he'll roll over on Joe and rub on him, and it's just night and day. And I think if we'd stayed...
Always loves. All kinds.
Come.
Well, he threw all those treats behind him. I'm sure he smelled all those treats over there. But, you know, this, I think, has been 10 times more beneficial than the other training I was taking him to. Because I think he would have been more aggressive if I had continued taking him to the other.
Let's go. Come. Come on.
Dodger.
I can smell it, dude.
Come.
Yeah. It's here. That's what you're smelling. It's my...